Well, hope all of you are doing fine, friends. So, the issue is, we need to first of all understand the concept about a wave and a particle. This is always a burning issue, and for the first time I'm making a video on this. So let me tell you very clearly about the fact that if you understand the basic distinction between the particle and the wave, so take it from me, 95% of your problems are resolved. About particles, we can conceptualize, we can understand and comprehend them very easily, but so far the waves are concerned, it's simply it troubles our mind. With the result, we feel scary about the wave concept, and later on we don't understand the topics well. Let me start with the basics. You can get all this information from other sites as well, undoubtedly so. But the way the things have to be communicated to you is somewhat that has to come from the heart. That has to come from the heart. I don't feel that people do it with heart as much as is required to make a better communication with the people, with the students, and making them help understand the things properly. Understand? So if you look at the particle nature, so particles are somewhat which is all around us. We are dealing with the particles more we deal with the waves. And the wave nature is somewhat quite a different innovation of science which has come to our lives recently. Recently, I mean, only a few decades before. But a particle, understanding in particle concept is atoms old with the humans. So we should first of all try to focus on the particle nature and then shift our focus to the wave nature, so that we understand it properly and the hurdles that we come across our path are somewhat eradicated. If you look at the particles, so particle has mass, it has some weight, you can weigh it. Particle occupies space, particles may have color. Particles may be colorless. Particles have density. Particles have some other properties, like we have a refractive index. Particles may have flow. Particles may have temperature. Particles may have pressure. So many properties are associated with the particles. Now, as long as the waves are concerned, waves are quite different than the particles. Say when I talk to you, I have got so many persons in front of me, and I talk to them. I choose a particular person to whom I want to talk exclusively. But once I talk, my talk is heard by everybody around me. So to the person whom I don't talk, want to get my talk heard, so it separates all over. So what is this? What is this thing that separates all over and is not localized and is not pointed to a point you are actually aiming at? What is it? So this is something that makes the emergence of the waves in our minds. Yeah, something is there, man, which is not to be taken or thought like particles and so on. So if you add two particles, for example, 1 kg, 1 kg weights of something, that's gonna be 2 kgs, okay? And if I tell you one thing, that if you have two waves, say sound and sound. Sound and sound, when they reinforce, when they combine or overlap or interfere with each other, you may get silence. You may get silence. So sound and sound can give you silence. And if you let them overlap or interfere in a different way, then the same sound and sound may give you loudness, a bigger sound, a bang. So this thing is not with the particle. So we have the things that we have to start with slowly and gradually. That particles and waves are quite different in their characters and their features and their characterizing properties from each other. And we need to understand them. I throw a particle to you, it goes to you only. Say, Mr. X. I throw my talk to you, it doesn't basically go to you only, it goes to everybody around me. So particles are localized in space. So particle has a particular space available to it. But waves are delocalized. They occupy all possible centers in the space whichever is, you know, available to them. And that's how I have started the journey now with particles and the waves. So I don't want to bore you in a single speech. So it will take time, and in the subsequent speeches, so I'm gonna try my level best to make you help understand the things with much ease, and that too, staying at home and having a sip of coffee along with. So allow me to have the series of these things taken with you in the subsequent lectures. So for now, I'll take your leave, and God bless you all.